Okay, everybody, this might be a bit of a quick one, but I really want to talk again about Stable Diffusion and Blender. If you're not sure what on earth that is, check out the channel. And down in the middle here is AI Tech and running Stable Diffusion locally with Blender add-on. Now, there have been some updates. Ben Rugg, the user here, has made some updates for a couple things that I think are really important. One is that you can now access what's called the stable horde, and that is essentially people that have allowed others to use their computer to create an image to then use, so that if you don't have a GPU to run this with or a powerful enough computer, then you can do that. So that's really handy. But the bigger change actually just recently is that there was a bug that broke it. And so Blender 3.5, which is what I'm running now, recently Blender 3.5 came out. Obviously, we update to the latest version. And so you're going to need that installed. Installation is, again, simple. Download it, go to Preferences, install, bang, you should be in. The only thing to keep note of is, so if we take a look inside of here, we should be able to see how we can have this run. So I've got mine running locally, so it runs straight on my computer. You can see I've got it in this window here, which is super handy. It saves time, saves money, because it doesn't cost anything compared to running it on Dreambooth. Now, inside of Blender, I've got a scene, and I'm going to talk about the scene because I want to show you inside of Stable Diffusion. If I tried to create, so I put in a mossy cube and a forest, and Stable Diffusion is pretty fantastic. It can come up with some pretty crazy stuff, and it's good, but it's not the composition that I want. That's why we use it with Blender. So I've got the 1.5 model running at the moment, and I've got this scene because I think I have an idea of how I want my scene to look like. So check us out. I'm going to go to the camera view, and I've got my cube sort of up in the air, and it should be sort of just sitting here with some trees right behind it, some blank over there, blank space over there. And when I run this, it's just, to me, it's just fascinating. So check us out. I put in a mossy cube in a forest of cedar trees. So I sort of modified just that I wanted cedar trees. The great thing about this plugin is it comes with all kinds of very cool, simple features, but cool features. One, negative prompts. It's great. Gets rid of a bunch of junk that you're generally going to want to get rid of. And then in here, we can apply a preset style, and these have improved. There are more. And so we're just going to go with 3D game because I like the look 3D game, artsy, yet kind of detailed. And then down in the advanced options, we're going to just have a random seed until I like it. And then I'll start to mess around with the image similarity, the steps, and the prompt strength, and the sampler. So I generally use Euler A as my sampler. There's a lot of samplers in here. Euler A is, in my opinion, one of the better ones, I guess you could say, ones that get the results that I want. Prompt strength is how much I want it to look like this prompt. I really, really do. So I've upped it to 10.5. Steps of 40, because my computer can handle lots of steps. And anything above 40 tends not to get that much better of an image anyways, but you can do it. And then image similarity down to 0.3. I'm going to show you what this will look like. So let's go ahead and render this really quickly. And you'll see that we'll get our window that shows our basic render, what it's going to look like. And then it makes a change. And this is what it looks like. So it's made sort of a mossy rock. So it's a little bit of moss. It's on grass. The composition is kind of what I'm looking for. But I think let's run it again. Let's see if we get a different result, which I believe we will. Yep, there's another result. So because my composition is set up that the ground is very green, it's interpreting that as grass, and then the trees are just sitting here in the background. But if, say, for example, we get the image similarity, we bring it up to, say, 0.67, something like that, and then we run this again, this is actually an interesting, I don't know if it's a feature, but very interesting in that it will barely change. So there's almost no change to this. So what we want to do is make sure that image similarity is way down. So 0.2, and let it have a little bit of fun. And we'll run this again. So point three was our first one. Now we're going to go to point two and see what Stable Diffusion does with this composition and these objects. Look at that. It's come up with something totally different again. But again, my cube is still sort of the same kind of approach. And this concept art is fascinating. And so here I've run one more time, and we can see that it's not very accurate at all. But down to point two, image similarity is really low. So it's not going. You have to be kind of careful about that stuff. Anyhow, so I want to just put a little bit of a reminder out there again of how cool this feature is, this plugin that has been created for free, essentially, that you can use to do your concept art, your conceptualizing of a thing. This is supposed to be a pencil drawing. That's not quite a pencil drawing. But, you know, that's just sort of the cube up here is, maybe. It's a bit of pencil drawing there. So, but this is amazingly fast. This is definitely something worth getting into Hudson River School. This is actually a really neat one. It's more like a painting sort of style. And really usually comes up with some pretty neat stuff. So check it out. If you Blender's free, the plugin's free, there's no cube. There's just this little cube here. But look at how foggy and neat this looks now. Very, very cool sort of style that you can use. So yeah, check it out. And here's a low poly one. We're already at low poly. Let's see what it does with this. It's a very low poly. And that's just it. Inside of Blender, you can just make a very, very low poly scene that, wow. That's easy to make and fast to make. So it's pretty cool stuff. Here's actually, I'll show you another one that I like. This one I did is the same style and everything. Put in all these little ferns and stuff, and it really does look like part of a video game. Slot two was nothing. Slot three, this was a neat one. It actually put a non-mossy cube inside of a forest with a bunch of moss. So fascinating stuff. Check it out. I'm going to leave it at that. Just letting you know the updates are out there. Everything's running as it should be. Stable Diffusion runs, Blender runs, and the plugin runs. It's great. So that's it for this one. I'll see you guys in the next one.